It sounds like science fiction, but countless neuroscientists and other professionals have shown that you literally can change the physical characteristics of your brain, sometimes simply by thinking. This is the core premise of John Arden's Rewire Your Brain, Think Your Way to a Better Life, and there are many, many books like this, but this one in particular refers to psychologist Donald Hebb's famous finding that neurons that fire together wire together. Oh, thank goodness for that, because that fact has saved my life. It's a statement that is now known as Hebb's Law or Hebbian Theory. Sharon Begley has done great work in showing how the ancient sages were right and why meditation literally changes the brain in Train Your Mind, Change Your Brain, another great study that includes research about how to increase neuroplasticity through meditation. I was skeptical of a lot of this stuff, but I've personally experienced the benefits described by Begley and countless other researchers, including the authors of How Enlightenment Changes Your Brain. I wrote up my experiences in The Victorious Mind. I've shared them at a TEDx event, and the long story short is, yes, you can rewire your brain. You can start doing it today, and I want to share with you how you can do it, why you should do it, and how to get started. This is Dr. Anthony Metivier from MagneticMaryMethod.com. Thanks for joining me for this episode of the Magnetic Mary Method podcast. Hit that thumbs up if you got one. Get subscribed if you aren't already. Let's get started with the basics. According to Dr. Tim Dauglish, rewiring your brain really comes down to intervention. For example, Dr. Dauglish and his research team have studied using memory-based interventions for depression and PTSD. This is really cool because these memory-based interventions are based on what's called Method of Loci or the Memory Palace Technique, and I had been benefiting from this long before I knew about these studies. My depression actually improved using exactly what they were talking about, and it was just a great, wonderful surprise. My student, Nick Castle, he reported relief from his PTSD, and I was so inspired by the survivor story that he shared on the Magnetic Mary Method podcast, I wrote an entire novel based on a lot of what he told me. Nick was a police officer, so his experiences with PTSD and overcoming them through neuroplastic change of his brain wound up becoming a huge theme in Flyboy. This novel literally shows how using memory techniques can help you not only solve crimes, but heal yourself after traumatic experiences. Now let's take this one step further, because after I did discover Tim Dauglish's research, I followed his suggestions in his studies, and that basically involves creating a different kind of memory palace than I've worked with before and placing 10 positive memories in the memory palace. So if you don't know what a memory palace is, very briefly, it's a mental reconstruction of a familiar location. And you would choose 10 spots, I call them magnetic stations. And so if you think about this bookshelf behind me, here's one spot, and I might have my first positive memory, which in my case was the day that I passed my PhD dissertation exam, and I started doing magic tricks for everybody in our post-dissertation defense celebration down in a pub called The Absinthe on York University campus. And so that's my first positive memory. Now, the idea of this is that you have 10 strung together, and when you have a situation of suffering, or you have negative thoughts that you'd rather not have, or negative memories are coming up due to PTSD or depression, you can defang them by entering your memory palace and triggering off these happy memories. And the more happy memories that you have in the memory palace, the more defang medicines you have, so to speak. I found this technique so useful. And so one thing that I did is explore even further to see just how much rewiring of my brain I could achieve. And one of the things that I did is I chose a home where I had really bad memories from my youth. And instead of letting those bad memories linger forever and a day, I memorized some very positive poetry written in Sanskrit in the form of a piece called the Atmabodha, sometimes called the Atma Shatakam, and because the world has to be complicated all the time, it's also sometimes called the Nirvana Shatakam. And going through this exercise of defanging a place with negative memories, I managed to not re-traumatize myself. I rewired my brain so that I can think about those memories without having this panic attack that I used to have, without having this anger about the past that I used to have. And as Tim Dauglish's research shows, All it took was an intervention. And in this case, it was a memory-based intervention. And that's ultimately the catch. If you want to enjoy a rewired brain, you have to have some kind of interruption or intervention. Now, I've got a bunch of activities that will help you have these positive interruptions, and just keep watching for 6 methods I've got for you that will help you rewire your brain with a specific emphasis on memory improvement. And as we go through this list, you know, you want to challenge your brain. These are challenging to take up. All of the books and the studies that I've cited today and many more that I've read, they always talk about taking on a mental challenge as the key to create transformation. And there's another very, very important ingredient, which is called time. So we not only want to have the challenge once, but we want to have it many times over time. And this is where I often try to make my transformational cycles at least 90 days with consistent practice throughout those 90 days, because it can take at least that long for the brain to form new neural pathways. There are a lot of brain chemicals involved. There's myelin sheaths, for example, and there are many studies where you can read about this. One of them is The Talent Code by Daniel Coyle. I highly recommend that book. So keep in mind that challenge over time. Those are the 2 secret ingredients in the special sauce that's going to make everything I'm about to share with you tick. Without taking on the challenge and without doing it over time, you're not really going to give yourself the ability to form new neuronal connections that will give you the experience that you seek. So even though when I talk about the Nirvana Shatakam or the Atma Shatakam that I memorized, and it did create a transformation for me with these negative memories in my past very, very quickly, this was as part of a longer journey. I'd already memorized a ton of Sanskrit, and so that transformation was much faster. But we're talking about more than 2 years of already working with Sanskrit. So I just came across this nasty negative memory located in a building of my youth and used these tools in order to root it out much more faster than you should expect if you're totally a beginner with these things. So you can build a brain of steel and get stronger and stronger as you go, but you got to start somewhere. Okay, so what is the first way that I suggest for experiencing rewiring of your brain? Well, for a lot of people, one of the easiest things to get started with is a simple set of activities called neurobics. It's basically aerobics for your brain. And a simple example is writing with your non-dominant hand. This will challenge parts of your brain that are normally not used. They're lying dormant. And, you know, there's different things you can do that are a little more interesting than, you know, flossing your teeth with the lights off or writing with a non-dominant hand. You can practice walking backwards or walking with your eyes closed, but you want to have somebody observing you so that you don't hurt yourself. So, you know, do not try this without sufficient supervision. Another thing that involves your eyes open that's totally safe to do is take different routes. This also counts as neurobics. And, you know, it revivify your brains, it forms new neural connections, or it revives ones that may have gone dormant if you haven't taken a particular route for a long time. And to take it to the next level, you can think about, okay, so I've driven this route X number of times. Have I ever walked it? And if not, try walking a route that you've normally only ever driven, making sure that it's safe to do so. And this can help with giving you this neurobic exercise that enlivens parts of the brain. Another thing to do is learn new skills. I mean, we've all heard that learning music is great for the brain, and that will require several levels of skill. Everything from how you're using your hands to how you're able to read circles in space on musical notation, and things like thinking about time and rhythm. These are all skill sets that create neural benefits, change in the brain. And the sooner you get into that stuff, wow, the sooner you're going to be able to experience those benefits. But you can also try other new skills. Like, for example, maybe you know how to bounce a ball against the ground, but can you bounce a ball with a hammer? So taking a tennis ball and a hammer and learning how to bounce and increase how many times you can bounce before the ball falls out of your control, that's a skill that can help build your brain. You can take up activities like card magic, which will help you learn not only dexterity with your hands, but also train your eyes. Gets into some audience management, the psychology of people around you. These are all very, very powerful. Another thing you can do is get into mental math, learning how to do calculations in different ways, speed math. All of this is going to challenge your current skills, stimulate your brain, and give you neuroplastic change. One of the best things of all, and many studies show this, bilingualism changes the brain in many positive ways. In fact, scientists are actively working on ways to make sure that more people get the message about this. And this is because language learning creates something that's called cognitive reserve. So this is a special benefit that helps people have their brains protect them from diseases like dementia and Alzheimer's. In fact, it's a little bit more nuanced than that. If you have enough cognitive reserve, you can actually get dementia and Alzheimer's and be less impacted than other people. And so, you know, it's science. The data may change over time, but there's so much to be gained from language learning. And, you know, if you'd like to get involved in certain programs around that, I have them for you at magneticmerrymethod.com through the Magnetic Merry Method Masterclass. You can learn, I've got three courses there on language learning. The key is, you know, try not to expect full fluency overnight or anything like that, but 90 days of practice with a language learning program and you're really, really focused on what are called the big five steps of language learning, reading, writing, speaking, listening, and memorizing, you're going to experience a lot of change in your brain, and it is very, very rewarding. Now, you might not be that into, you know, things like language learning. So there's ways to play games that provide a certain level of cognitive training that can lead to neuroplastic change. The trick is to find solid brain games that legitimately challenge you, and they're not just distractions. So Dr. Christine Till, she's one scientist who has studied some of the apps that claim to have benefits through brain game gamification, so to speak. But, you know, she's skeptical of it, I'm skeptical of it, and basically what she found is that a lot of these apps really only provide a benefit if you have a human coach that's working with you on the app. That totally makes sense to me. Why? Because the human would be helping make sure that you're actually using it to get the challenge. And a lot of us, we look at the challenge on the app and we either cheat or we give up too early, etc., so we never get the benefit. So I would never really say that it's impossible to get challenge from an app, but for a lot of us, it's much, much less likely, and that's what Christine Till's research shows. Now, another way to get neuroplastic change is read, and read a lot. Now, there's a lot to still be understood about reading and how it transforms the brain in many ways, but the real way to think about it is to not make it about reading alone. Always think of reading as paired with writing. Now, I don't mean that you necessarily have to write a book yourself, but as memory expert Lynn Kelly has shown in her own study of memory, the hand is the ultimate encryption device. So if you take notes by hand, you're going to remember more of what you're reading. So reading should always be about writing. Now, another thing to do, and this is my personal favorite, to keep your neural pathways strong is to use memory techniques. Improving your memory is a way of rewiring your brain that starts, I believe, with attention and confidence. So I meet many people who say, oh, I could never learn how to remember names. They see me at an event, I remember all the names, oh, I can never do that. Well, that's a lack of confidence. Just getting into using the memory techniques already starts to change the brain because you realize how easy it is, and then you get the confidence with the techniques. You can use the techniques to remember lists using simple rhymes. So you could learn the number rhyme method. One is a gun, two is a shoe, three is a bee, four is a door, etc. That's just a very simple way to get into it. And just learning those rhymes themselves will start to give you change. I am an advocate of what I would call holistic memory improvement, which is just to dive into the deep end, get into memory techniques, make it part of your daily activity set, make it part of your meditation, and think about memory improvement as a dietary thing. There are foods that can help preserve and improve your memory. There's just everything to be gained by getting into memory improvement from top to bottom. And if you'd like more information, I've got a free course at magneticmerrymethod.com. And remember, although it's free, it's going to challenge you. So I would suggest everything there is something that you complete. You actually take action on and you repeat that action in order to really start to experience the change. Now, this is really, really important that you take positive action with training that challenges you, because there's a lot of negative training out there. We are repeating negative messages on the internet all the time. You can't even use the internet without encountering them. So we are talking about ads and all of the many, many nasty messages that come through, political stuff and yada, yada, yada. And I'm not saying that it should be avoided necessarily, but I would hope that you can see that it's the dark side of neuronal change in your brain. You can literally be caused through propaganda to completely lose the ability to think critically about issues, to have an emotional attachment to certain outcomes that have been presented to you through emotionally manipulating images and language and rhetoric and themes. And this is something that you need to cultivate an awareness about and challenge yourself to, if you don't already, have more of the other side and be willing to make that change if you're going to engage in those kinds of debates, because positive change is possible. It might not be easy, but the rewards are there and they are massive. This is what the Magnetic Mary Method Initiative is all about. I got one more suggestion for you, but thank you for your thumbs up. Thanks for being subscribed if you aren't already subscribed. And for everybody who leaves comments, I always love hearing from you and engaging with you. Now, when it comes to making interventions, time is both your worst enemy and your best friend. So I suggest that instead of blindly following the advice that says, you know, do all the important stuff first thing in the morning when your energy is high, start to explore yourself and your patterns through an activity like journaling. It may be true for you that the morning is your best time to get the most important things done, but you want to explore all of this through what's called a learning cycle. And if you'd like to learn more about a learning cycle, is how to use learning cycles to rewire your brain, either look up the Magnetic Mary Method podcast episode on learning cycles next, or follow the link that should appear on the screen if you're watching on YouTube, or is down in the description below. Thanks again, and until we have a chance to meet again, keep yourself magnetic.